So now let us focus on the reaction of metal. So in this reactions you have to know about the Wood's reaction. Wood's reaction. Then Wood's fatigue reaction. Wood's fatigue reaction. And you have to know about the fatigue reaction. Fatigue reaction. And one more reactions, that is Grignard reagents. So this is the
all you know about the reaction with metal.
So now first of all,
look the difference in Wood's reaction, Wood's fatigue reaction and fatigue reactions.
Here substrate is alkyl halide. Alkyl halide, that is RX. Here substrate is alkyl and aryl halide mixture. That means in this reaction RX and ARX will be the substrate, but in fatigue reactions the substrate is only aryl halide. So this is the common difference
in all the three. Now
here all react with sodium in presence of dry ether. It also react with sodium in presence of dry ether. It also react with sodium in presence of dry ether.
So this is the basic requirement of to learn the reaction with the metal. Now let us focus on in detail about the Wood's reaction. So first of all, you have to know about the Wood's reaction in detail. Look at here, Wood's reaction. Now what happened here? Basically alkyl halide, how can you define the Wood's reaction? Here alkyl halide react with sodium in dry ether. Dry ether will give hydrocarbon, having double number of carbon atom than the parent alkyl halide. So this is basically the definition of Wood's reactions. That means in case of Wood's reactions, what happens? Alkyl halide react with sodium in dry ether to give hydrocarbon which have double number of carbon than the parents alkyl halide have. So now look the reaction. This is also important, name reactions. So now look at here, RX plus 2Na when react with, again you are taking the alkyl halides in presence of dry ether. So now look at here, what happens? The X of alkyl halide are removed with Na, and now one bond is formed between R and R, and this will give 2NaX. Now this, when you break this bond, you get the symmetrical alkene, that symmetrical hydrocarbon. So this is basically symmetrical alkane. That means
having even number of carbon atom.
That means the product have always even number of carbon atom. Now look one example, C2H5 Cl plus 2Na. Again you can take Cl C2H5. Now in presence of dry ether. Now again here the Cl removed with Na now, and the bond formed between C2H5 and C2H5. So this will gives butane having again even number of carbon atom.
Look at here the parent alkyl halide contain 2 carbon, but the hydrocarbon formed by this reaction is contains 4 carbon. That is just double the number of carbon atom, and also this can form the hydrocarbon having even number of carbon atom, and this is also known as symmetrical alkene. So this is the basic example of Purge reaction. Now some notable points which are also very important for examination point of view. So first of all, look at here in note, if ether is wet, one question arises, if ether is wet, that means if we take in the mass ether, in that condition what happens? If ether is wet, then product will be alcohol, then the product is alcohol. Now what happened basically here, ki Na sodium react with water, so now it will gives 2NaOH plus liberate hydrogen atom. Now this NaOH react with alkyl halides, that's why this will change into alcohol. So now when this will react with alkyl halides NaOH, so now the product is alcohol. So that's why you have to keep avoid using the wet ether. Now some more points you have to note down, that a tertiary alkyl halide do not give the Purge reaction. So second point in the note, 3° alkyl halide do not give Purge reaction. In this case the product is eliminated product. Now one more point I noted down, that if we take the different alkyl halides, so different alkyl halide gives mixture of hydrocarbon which cannot be separated easily, So look at here, that means by this reaction you cannot prepare the hydrocarbon which are unsymmetrical. So now look the reactions. In case of if you take the mixture of alkyl halides, so what happened here? Just we have taken the CH3Cl plus 2Na plus C2H5Cl. So look the conditions, dry ether. What happened here basically? Now this will give the product CH3. When this alkyl halide react with this alkyl halides, so the product is alkane. When this react with same molecules, so now the product is butane. One more thing happened, this alkyl halide react with this alkyl halides, so now this will gives C2H5 and CH3. So this will gives ethane, butane and propane. तो दैट्स वाई दिस गिव द मिक्सचर ऑफ एल्किन्स. तो हैंस दिस मेथड इज नॉट सुटेबल फॉर प्रिपरेशन ऑफ अनसिमेट्रिकल एल्केन दैट इज हाइड्रोकार्बन. नाउ समटाइम वी कैन यूज दिस टाइप ऑफ रिएक्शन ऑल्सो इन दिस वे. हियर सी एल गिवन, हियर वी आर गिवन एंड अ कंडीशन गिवन सोडियम इन प्रेजेंस ऑफ ड्राई ईथर. तो दिस इंडिकेट द वुड्स रिएक्शन. नाउ व्हाट हैपेंस, वन एन ए टेक दिस वी आर एंड वन एन ए टेक दिस सी एल एंड नाउ द प्रोडक्ट इज अ टाइप ऑफ बाईसाइक्लो कंपाउंड. तो दिस टाइप ऑफ कंपाउंड में भी फॉर्म. तो दिस इज ऑल्सो वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर एग्जामिनेशन पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू. दैट मीन्स दिस टाइप ऑफ क्वेश्चन मे बी आस्क्ड इन द बोर्ड एग्जामिनेशन. नाउ डियर स्टूडेंट्स, लेट अस फोकस ऑन वन मोर प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ वुड्स रिएक्शन. दैट मीन्स इट फॉलो फ्री रेडिकल मैकेनिज्म. फ्री रेडिकल मैकेनिज्म हैंस डू नॉट सॉरी हैंस डिसप्रोपोर्शनेट एंड गिव एल्कीन आल्सो. लुक एट हियर व्हाट हैपेंस, C2H5 कंटेनिंग डॉट एंड प्लस C2H5 कंटेनिंग डॉट. नाउ 1H मूव टू दिस साइड, 1H इन द फॉर्म ऑफ मूव टू दिस साइड. तो व्हाट हैपन हियर, नाउ रिमूवल ऑफ 1H दैट मीन्स ऑक्सीडेशन, एडिशन ऑफ 1H दैट इज रिडक्शन. तो दैट्स व्हाई दिस रिएक्शन इज नोन एज डिसप्रोपोर्शनेशन रिएक्शन. दिस आई ऑल्सो टोल्ड यू इन क्लास 11, ऑक्सीडेशन स्टेट दैट इज रिडॉक्स रिएक्शन. नाउ योर आंसर इज C2H4 प्लस C2S6. तो दिस इज ईथीन एंड दिस इज ईथीन. दिस इज ऑल्सो वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर एग्जामिनेशन पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू. कि वन क्वेश्चन मे बी राइज कि वाई द सम टाइम एल्कीन्स ऑल्सो फॉर्म. तो दिस इज ड्यू टू डिसप्रोपोर्शनेशन एंड दिस इज ड्यू टू फ्री रेडिकल मैकेनिज्म. तो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज ऑल अबाउट वुड्स रिएक्शन. नाउ लेट अस फोकस ऑन सेकेंड रिएक्शन, फेटिग रिएक्शन. फेटिग रिएक्शन हियर व्हाट हैपेंस, एरिल हैलाइड्स दैट मीन्स यू कैन टेक क्लोरोबेंजीन देन रिएक्ट विथ टू सोडियम. हियर ऑल्सो यू टेक इन वन मोर क्लोरोबेंजीन. नाउ अगेन द एन ए रिमूव विथ दिस सी एल एंड नाउ द प्रोडक्ट इज हियर बाईफेनिल्स दैट इज ऑल्सो नोन एज डाईफेनिल. तो हियर द प्रोडक्ट इज डाई आर यू कैन से बाईफेनिल. दिस इज ऑल्सो हार्मफुल प्रोडक्ट. तो इन केस ऑफ वुड्स रिएक्शन व्हाट हैपन व्हेन एरिल हैलाइड्स रिएक्ट विद सोडियम इन प्रेजेंस ऑफ ड्राई ईथर. तो दिस विल गिव्स बाईफेनिल्स आर ड्राई फेनिल्स आर सिमिलर एनालॉग. तो दिस इज अ जनरल क्वेश्चन विथ वुड्स रिएक्शन सॉरी फिटिंग रिएक्शंस. नाउ वन मोर रिएक्शन यू हैव टू नोटेड डाउन दैट अबाउट द वुड्स फिटिंग रिएक्शंस. दिस आई टोल्ड यू जस्ट इन केस ऑफ फिटिंग रिएक्शंस एरिल हैलाइड्स आर टेकन एज ए सबस्टेट बट इन केस ऑफ वुड्स फिटिंग वन एल्किल हैलाइड्स एंड वन एरिल हैलाइड्स शुड बी टेकन हियर. नाउ सोडियम अगेन इट विल रिएक्ट विथ क्लोरोबेंजीन. तो नाउ दिस गिव इज द मिक्सचर ऑफ एल्किल हैलाइड्स एंड एरिल हैलाइड्स. नाउ हियर अगेन दिस बॉन्ड इज ब्रेक एंड नाउ द प्रोडक्ट इज एल्किल एरिल दैट इज एल्किल बेंजीन ड्राई ईथर. नाउ दिस विल गिव्स द प्रोडक्ट एल्किल बेंजीन दैट इज मेथिल बेंजीन मेथिल बेंजीन इज द प्रोडक्ट एंड दिस इज ऑल्सो नोन एज टॉलविन. दिस इज ऑल्सो वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट केमिकल्स फॉर एग्जामिनेशन पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू. नाउ दीज आर ऑल अबाउट द सिंपल रिएक्शन विद द मेटल. सो नाउ लेट अस फोकस वन मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट कंपाउंड दैट इज ग्रिगनार्ड रिएजेंट्स. ग्रिगनार्ड रिएजेंट्स दिस इज ऑल्सो नोन एज ऑर्गेनो मेटैलिक कंपाउंड. नाउ तो वन क्वेश्चन मे बी राइजेज व्हाइट इज नोन एज ऑर्गेनो मेटैलिक कंपाउंड. तो दिस इज ड्यू टू सी एम जी बॉन्ड. नाउ लेट अस फोकस ऑन द ग्रिगनार्ड रिएजेंट्स. तो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल यू हैव टू नो दैट व्हाट इज द ग्रिगनार्ड रिएजेंट्स. सो दिस इज ऑल्सो यू कैन लर्न बाय दिस वे राम जी का एक्स दैट इज आर एम जी एक्स. नाउ लुक एट हियर हियर द बॉन्ड बिटवीन द एम जी एंड एक्स. एक्स इज बेसिकली हैलाइड आयंस. तो द बॉन्ड बिटवीन एम जी एंड एक्स इज आयनिक बॉन्ड. And this I told you that ionic bond is the strongest bond. So that's why here the breaking of bond take place generally in between R and Mg. So this is ionic bond and this is highly polar covalent bond. So first of all you have to know about the bonding. So this contains two type of bonding. One covalent bond between the R and Mg and one ionic bond between Mg and X. So due to this, this got negative positive charge and now the R got negative charge. Then all the reactions of Grignard agents, this contains negative charge and this contains positive charge. And basically, whatever you know in the board examinations, you have to break this bond only. Now dear students, here R may be, now what is the R? R may be alkyl group, that is ethyl methyl propyl. May be aryl group, may be benzene ring. It is may be R alkyl. R alkyl means they are contains alkyl group and aryl group both. Either it may be alkenyl group, that means double bonded carbon, that is alkene, or it may be alkynyl group. Alkynyl group. So these are basically may be R. So that's why we can form number of product by using Grignard reagents and hence Grignard got Nobel Prize for this. Now let us focus on the preparation of Grignard reagents. So first of all preparation of Grignard reagent. Look at here, how will this prepared? Here R X, here X may be Cl, Br and I, but most of the case we are taken Br. When react with Mg metal in presence of dry ether, here dry means without water. Now the product is RMgX. This is known as Grignard reagents. Now you can take one example, CS3, CS2, Br plus Mg in presence of dry ether. So now the product is CS3, CS2, Mg and Br. Now how you write the name of this chemical? So this is ethyl magnesium bromide. So the name of this Grignard reagent is ethyl magnesium bromide. So this is all about the preparation of Grignard reagents. Now let us focus on some noteworthy points regarding the preparation of Grignard reagents. So first point in note, ki water or you can say or any other compound having proton, that means that can liberate proton, is not used as medium because the product will be hydrocarbon. So when what happened basically,
the water or any other compound which can release a proton, that means that can have a protons and can be released the protons,
do not taken as medium because the product may be hydrocarbon.
So now look at here, what happened basically,
we are taken RMgX. This I told you that only the breaking of bond between R and Mg take place. Now here we take water or any other compounds, H and H2, that is ammonia, or we can take in
HOR, that is alcohol,
or we can take in H C triple bond CH,
that is alkyne,
or you can take in H SH.
In each case what happens,
this contains proton. So now these proton will react with the R and the product is always RH in all these cases.
But the byproduct is, in this case what happened,
MgX and OH. So in first case what happened with the byproduct, the MgX OH. In second case what happens, the byproduct is MgX NH2. In third case the byproduct is MgX OR. In next case MgX C triple bond CH, okay, and lastly MgX and SH.
So these are the basically the byproduct in all these cases, but the main product is always hydrocarbon. So that's why ether should be dry. So this is the reason. So one question may be raised, why we take in the ether dry? So because the moist ether always gives you hydrocarbon
like this. This depend upon the R. If the R is benzene ring, in that condition you will get aromatic hydrocarbon. If the R is alkyl group, so that means you can get alkane. So now look one conditions, if we are taken R Mg like X like this, so here R is benzene ring, Mg, and we taken the Cl. Now what happens with the moist ether, look at here. Now the product is benzene, this is aromatic hydrocarbon, that I told you that it contains negative charge, this contains positive charge, so here H plus attack to this carbon. Now the product is aromatic hydrocarbon and the byproduct is this. So this is basically aromatic hydrocarbon and that is known as benzene.
So by using the different R you can get the different type of hydrocarbon.
So now some more points you noted down, that why ether be taken. So second point, ether provide a medium and stabilize Grignard region by process of solvation. The general ether, what taken be it? Not taken generally. So the general ether is diethyl ether. That means C2H5O C2H5. Just like in case of alcohol, so the general alcohol is ethyl alcohol. Now to look the conditions, R, Mg and X. So this are solvated by ether like this. So due to solvation,
the Grignard reagent is more stable in dry ether. Now some more important points regarding the Grignard reagents. So these are all about the preparation. One more point, so note it down that the order of reactivity of alkyl halides for the Grignard reagents is the rate of formation of the third point, rate of formation of Grignard reagents will depend upon the alkyl halides. Ri are more reactive than RBr, RBr is more reactive than RCl. But in most of the case, we have to prefer RBr. Now, let us focus on the properties of Grignard reagents. So now, dear students, let us focus on the properties of Grignard reagents. The properties of Grignard reagents. This is most and most important. This property will cover three chapters: haloalkanes, halogens, alcohol, phenol, ether, and aldehyde, ketone, and acid. So now let us focus here again. So first of all, you have to focus on the physical property. So basically, these are the first point. These are non-volatile, colorless solid. Here volatile means tendency to form vapor, but it is non-volatile, so they do not have the tendency to form vapor. Now second, formation of alcohol. So this will be urine, the preparation of alcohol. So formation of 1 degree, 2 degree, and 3 degree alcohol by using Grignard reagents. So look at here, dear students. When Grignard reagents react with the formaldehyde, so this is known as methanol in IUPAC name, and common name is known as formaldehyde. So now look on conditions. We are taking the RMGX, okay, or may be changed. So now what happens? This bond always break to this side. This I told you, O is more electronegative than carbon. So that's why pi bond shifted towards oxygen atom. This I told you, an electromeric effect. So now in presence of dry ether, what happened here? So this R have a negative charge, this have positive charge. So the R goes to this carbon atom. So now what happened here? O MgX and this are joined by this carbon. So this is known as basically adduct. Adduct means addition product. Here addition take place, so that's why this is known as adduct. Now again what happens? The hydrolysis take place. In this hydrolysis what happens? This bond break, and you know that water contains H plus and OH minus. So OH goes to the oxygen atom, and H plus goes to the oxygen atom, and OH goes to the Mg. So now by this way you can form the alcohol. Now look the conditions: OH and plus Mg X and OH. So now look at here, this carbon attached to one carbon atom, so that's why this is known as 1 degree alcohol. So you can prepare 1 degree alcohol by using formaldehyde. Now similar things can be happen if aldehyde other than formaldehyde we are taken. So look the conditions here. If we taken the aldehydes other than formaldehyde, in that conditions we are taken the aldehyde other than formaldehyde. Look only focus here, what is the change occurs here? H is there, but now we have taken the C. That's why now this is known as acetaldehyde in common name, acetaldehyde in common name, and in IUPAC name it is known as ethanol. So many times the question arises, how can you prepare the alcohol from ethanol? Now again we are taking the R MgX, same thing happen here, negative positive charge, this bond break towards oxygen due to more electronegativity. Now look again here, what happens? O MgX, negative charge positive charge, and this R placed to here.
Now this is CH3. So again this is addition product, that is known as adduct. Now what happens here? After this you have to do the hydrolysis. So now what happens? This bond break here H plus. You have to add here, you have to add OH minus. Now just think about this CH3 C OH and this contains R. Now this carbon attached by the 2 carbon atom, so that's why this is 2 degree alcohol. So by this way you can prepare 2 degree alcohol. So formaldehyde other than, sorry, aldehyde other than formaldehyde always gives you 2 degree alcohol. Now third case, that is we have to prepare 3 degree alcohol. So now we are taking the example of acetone. So now this formula become acetone. Now look the conditions, what a change occurs here. So the common name of this formula is acetone and the IUPAC name of this is propanone. Propanone, 1, 2, 3 carbon and 2 carbon contains ketone. Now look the condition, what is changing here? No change occurs here, only change of this. This become also CH3 and after this you can also write the CH3. So this is the mechanism of reactions also. So now look the conditions, this carbon attached to 3 carbon atom and hence this is known as 3 degree alcohol and everything are same. So just you have to look properly the mechanism of one and you can write the mechanism of all the three. So again what you find here, by looking this reactions, if when Grignard reagents react with the formaldehyde, that will always gives 1 degree alcohol. When Grignard reagents react with other aldehydes, so this will gives 2 degree alcohol. When Grignard reagents react with the acetone, that means ketone, in that condition you always get 3 degree alcohol. So that's why up now look the conditions, this chemical basically belong to the haloalkanes. So the property of haloalkanes also you read here this is the basically aldehyde ketone and here what happens? Now we have to learn here property of ketone also, and now here what happen? We have to learn the preparation of alcohol. So by this reactions you can go through 3 chapter: alcohol, phenol ether, aldehyde ketone acid and haloalkanes. Now this is the preparation of 1 degree 2 degree 3 degree alcohol. Now dear students, let us focus on preparation of carboxylic acid. So preparation of carboxylic acid. So now again you can prepare the carboxylic acid also. So look the conditions, CO2, this is CO2, here the bond angle is 180 degree, you know that this carbon is sp hybridized. Now what happen here? Again if this bond is break towards the oxygen, and now when RMeX reacts with this CO2, so now you get O double bond C O MgX and this carbon now attached by R. Again hydrolysis take place, you can break the bond in the presence of water. Due to hydrolysis this bond break between the O and Mg, and now you will get O double bond C OH and R. You can write like this also, R C O H. So this is the carboxylic acid and now the byproduct is MgX and OH. So by using the different type of R you can get the different number of carboxylic acid having different number of carbon atom also, and you can increase the carbon chain. If you take in the 2 carbon, now acid the containing 3 carbon. If you use the 1 carbon, so the acid have 2 carbon. So now by this way you can prepare the carboxylic acid. Now let us focus on how we can prepare aldehyde and ketone by using the Grignard reagents. So now preparation of aldehyde and ketone. So that's why this chemical is much important for examination point of view also. So now when hydrogen cyanide, this I also told you, if this bond is break towards the nitrogen due to more electronegativity,
this you can learn from the electromeric effect. Again here RMGX, same thing happen here, negative charge, positive charge, this R moved to this carbon and now Mg attached to the N. Now what happen here, basically HC double bond N MgX and this contains R. Now again hydrolysis take place, and by hydrolysis here you have to break this bond. So now this is the negative charge, this is the positive charge, so that's why 2OH come to this carbon. And now look the condition, what happens, H C OH OH and R. So now dear students, let us focus here. 2OH cannot be stabilized, this carbon compound, so that's why here what happens, one water molecules are removed, and by removal of one water molecules what happens, one sigma bond break, so that's why one pi bond is formed. So now what happens, HC double bond O R, this you can written like this RCH, so this is basically aldehyde. So that means we can prepare aldehydes only by the hydrogen cyanide. Now if we change the hydrogen cyanide, that is alkyl cyanides, so this is basically, you can know that 1,2 carbon, that means 1,2 carbon ethane, and CN is known as nitrile. So this is known as ethane nitrile. Now look the condition here. Here again this becomes CH3, and here again this becomes CH3, this again becomes CH3. So now what happens? This carbon attached by the 2 carbon atom, and this carbon contains double bond. So this is known as ketone. This you can write like this R double bond O and CH3. So this is known as ketone. Now the ketone having different number of carbon atom, this depend upon the only R. That means you can increase the more carbon number atom here also in case of ketone. So this is the preparation of aldehydes and ketone. So now I am giving the some questions to solve you. So look at here, how will you prepare? Now this type of question may be given. This contains this is basically CH2, Mg and Br. Now it will react with formaldehyde. So how you can write the answer? So look at here, this whole compound will move to this carbon, and now this O you can join 1H. So now the product will be HCHOH, and this join the CH2 and benzene ring. You can write this also like this, benzene ring, CH2, CH2 and OH. That means you can prepare 1 degree alcohol, so this is also 1 degree alcohol. You can also write the name 1,2, so 2 phenyl and ethanol, so this is name as 2 phenyl and 2 carbon ethane, and you have to put all for OH. So one question may be raised, how can you prepare 2 phenyl ethanol from formaldehyde? So by using the Grignard reagents you can prepare this compound. So now students, these are all about the reaction with the metals. Now listen the video lecture properly and try to solve some question given in the NCERT book. Thank you dear students.